scared when the angel came to her. There was one main angel called Gabriel. He was just a boy angel.
She had wings and she was all white.
The angel said, "You're gonna have a special baby."
And it was God's son.
She was quite excited.
A bit scared.
And she was like, "Oh my gosh, I'm gonna have the son of God." And then she was like, "I can't, I'm not married and stuff."
Joseph, he was a builder. Mary told Joseph that she was having a baby called Jesus and it was God's son.
He's like, "What?"
Then Joseph saw the angel in a dream.
I think Joseph was really scared.
And then they went to Bethlehem.
On a donkey.
It'd be quite hot.
She had a baby in her tummy and she would have been really heavy.
She said,
"Can we stop anywhere with these houses?"
They had to try and find somewhere for Mary to have the baby.
They went around a whole neighbourhood.
No, there's no space.
Everyone said no in an angry voice because it was the middle of the night.
I said no!
The last innkeeper,
he said, "Yeah, there's a barn type thing around the back."
They had to go to a barn and have their baby.
It had sheeps.
It was like all hay and sheep and things.
Mary put baby Jesus in one of those troughs.
They call the baby Jesus and they loved him. And he has two daddies, God and Jesus. They both needed to look after the baby.
The angel told the shepherds to follow the star.
There was three kings.
They followed the star all the way to where Jesus was born.
When they get to the stable, they give them Jesus the presents.
And then they got some angels as visitors too. And then there was a giant star. Everyone was there.
Then there was a party.
Yeah. Christ was born.
Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, and mild and sweet their songs repeat, of peace on earth, goodwill to men, and the bells they're ringing. Like a choir that's singing, and in my heart I hear them, peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I say. Hate is strong and mocks the song. Peace on earth, goodwill to men. But the bells they're ringing, like a choir they're singing. Is anybody here? On earth, goodwill and ringing singing on its way. The world revolved from night to day. A voice, a chime, a chant sublime. Peace on earth, goodwill to men.
I hope you brought your very best singing voice tonight, because you're going to get to join the choir and orchestra for this next medley of Christmas carols. There'll be Christmas songs that everybody in the room knows, and I just want you to sing full force tonight. Are you ready to join this choir and orchestra to sing? Let's give it a try. Here we go. One, two, three, and...
Oh,
done. Give yourself a nice big hand tonight. Thank you.
that your baby boy would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels tried? And when you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Oh man, did you know? Ooh, ooh, maybe did you know?
You're almost where the stand adore you, O holy child of heaven.
O God incarnate, one with the Holy Spirit and with the Father, we lift our songs of praise. Redeeming love.
Each year as we put this production together, I'm amazed at how many volunteers in the church sign up to assist and to help to make sure you have a wonderful experience tonight. Hundreds and hundreds of volunteers put this production together, and lots of rehearsals, months and months of rehearsals to prepare the music for tonight. So we thought we'd show you tonight a little behind-the-scenes video of what takes place to get ready for you coming tonight. Here's the video. Thank you.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
No crown is worn, but angels worship him. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Almighty God, so meek, so mild, salvation comes through this holy child.
A king is born.
He's in a manger now. Humbly come and humbly bow. Oh, reaching out his tiny hand. This day in Bethlehem.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Shepherds bow down to his holy face.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Heaven is seen of peace on earth, filled with the wonder of his birth.
A king is born.
He's in a manger now.
A king is born.
Humbly come and humbly bow.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us.
And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger.
Thank you. river, hope like a fountain, joy like the morning. God is here. Rest for the weary, grace for the broken, mercy for sinners. God is here. So come, adore.
Beautiful job. Thanks, Mark. This is salvation. Everything that we've done from the beginning of this concert to this moment, the reason why we do these concerts in the first place is for this moment to proclaim to you, this is salvation. This is God's gift to you. Out of his unconditional, irrepressible, irrepayable, inexhaustible love, God gave a gift. He gave Jesus Christ to be the Savior of the world, to be the Lord of all, to bring eternal life to all who would receive it. The Bible says, for the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You know, this year again is our tradition in our family. Linda and I will place gifts under the tree in anticipation of our family coming for Christmas, our children and grandchildren. And, you know, we can't imagine those gifts being refused when Christmas Day comes or ignored. We can't imagine anything other than these loved ones receiving these gifts with joy and love and gratitude and appropriating the gifts for themselves. God has given a gift. The Bible describes it so well, so simply, so profoundly in John 3:16, the most well-loved, well-known verse in all the Bible. For God so loved the world that he gave a gift. He gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him, places saving faith, trust in him, will not perish because of their sin, but will have everlasting life. This is salvation. This is God's gift. There's a line in that song that says, God is here. God is here. God is literally here in this place right now by the power of the Holy Spirit. And once again, he wants to give the gift of salvation to those who have not received it. Have you received that gift? Have you received the gift personally for yourself with gratitude? Embrace it, receive it, bring it into your own life, appropriate it, and let it make a difference in your life. You know, just because you were born in a Christian nation or born into a Christian family or you go to church a lot doesn't mean that you've received personally the gift of salvation. You have to receive it personally. I want to give you an opportunity to do that tonight. I'm going to pray a final prayer, and as we do, this is your opportunity, just a prayer of faith to say, God, I want to receive this gift that you've given through Jesus Christ. So I'm going to ask you to bow your head if you would. Would you please do that? Just bow your head and close your eyes. Everyone just taking this moment to contemplate what's been said. No one looking around. Let's just make this a private moment between you and God. And if you would like to receive this gift tonight, maybe you've never done this. Maybe you just kind of assumed that because, you know, you're American, you're saved. But you've not personally said, Jesus, I want you in my life. Or maybe you did. Maybe you made that commitment a long time ago, but really you've not been living a life that exemplifies that. You've not been living with Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. Tonight, you want to recommit your life to him. I'm going to invite you to pray this prayer. I'm going to ask for the house lights to come up just a little bit so that I can see. But if you want to be included in this prayer to receive this gift of God tonight for the first time or maybe recommitting your life, I'm going to ask you to express that through an action that will activate your faith, I believe, and that is for you to raise your hand and say, Pastor Ray, would you pray for me? Would you include me in this prayer? You know, scores and scores, dozens and dozens of people so far in these four previous concerts have committed their lives to Christ, have received the gift of salvation. You know, over these 30 years, literally thousands of people have done this, and I'm going to invite you to join them. It's the most important, best decision you can ever make in your life. So before I pray, I wonder how many people all over this place would just lift a hand up and say, Pastor Ray, include me in this prayer. I want to receive the gift of eternal life. I want to personally invite Jesus into my heart. I see your hand. Thank you. Just lift it up right now. Let me see it real quickly. Thank you. Others, thank you. Thank you. Just looking over the bottom floor. Thank you. Just slip it up so I can see it. Just hold it up for a second and I'll see it. And I see your hand. I see your hand. Thank you. You can put it down. Thank you. Thank you over here. If you lifted your hand and you really do want to receive the gift of eternal life through Jesus Christ, then I'm going to lead us in a prayer, and I'm going to ask you to make this prayer by faith. Make this prayer your prayer, and God will hear you. He will respond to you, and he will do what he's promised to do. He'll forgive your sins, and he will give you the gift of eternal life. So that no one will be embarrassed, we're all going to pray this together. So I'm going to lead and you follow every voice. Let's pray. Dear Lord Jesus, I come to you tonight And I confess that I'm a sinner. I need to be forgiven. So would you forgive me? I invite Jesus to come into my heart, to be my Savior, to be my Lord. And from this day forward, with your help, I will give him control of my life. I will live for him. And best of all, thank you for giving me the gift of eternal life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Ray. And just thank you again for attending tonight. We're going to invite all of our choirs back onto this stage as we sing, O Come All Ye Faithful. And then we're going to conclude tonight with the Hallelujah Chorus. I'm guessing there's probably several of you in the audience tonight that have at some point in your life sung in a choir and maybe have sung the Hallelujah Chorus. So we're going to invite you to join this wonderful choir and orchestra as well to join us as we conclude together. Here we go.
one last time. Would you give a big cheer to the choirs of Portland Christian Center? Show them your appreciation. And how about the Celebration Orchestra? Would you say thank you to them as well for a job well done? And our sound and lighting team, show your appreciation for them as well. Job well done, guys. Good job. And, of course, our producer and director for 30 straight years now, Pastor Ron and Cheryl Cochran, say thank you to these guys. And once again, thank you to all of you for being our guests tonight. And last but not least, from all of us at Portland Christian Center, to all of you, we want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.